up YouTube? Topaz Yates back for another album review. And this one is to that Kevin Gates that is live, which he named this after his daughter, which I believe that is how you're supposed to pronounce it. Not sure though. I mean, my thing about Kevin Gates, man, he's more of just an average rapper that really sticks to his strengths and such, man. I mean, if you look at the way the music industry has been going for quite some time, he's more closer to above average because he actually has the talent to rap, while most rappers who getting put on, besides just a handful of really talented, gifted people and shit, have all been damn fucking terrible. So in comparison to all the terrible rappers, man, he's really good, but yet in comparison to the really good ones, he's really not standing out by any means. I mean, I do give him respect for rapping what he knows and shit, even though he be on some super weird, odd type shit. But he really raps what he's about, man. He got a decent flow. His delivery is cool. But my thing is, emotionally, you can get better tracks out of a guy like Lil Boosie than you would get from Kevin Gates. See, Kevin Gates does a better job than a guy like 2 Chainz, but yet once you start climbing up the ranks of rappers and such, man, then you realize he's not that strong. And once you listen to this project, man, a bunch of interesting tracks like that 2 Phones, which was his single that I hear in the damn club all the motherfucking time, man, it's catchy, but it's not anything phenomenal though. I already made a video for that Truth song where he's talking about why he assaulted his fans and such, which that was interesting in its own right. That No One track was cool, man, where he's pretty much telling these women who's always calling him a dog and all that, like, it takes one to know one because I know your type. And as much as I love that concept, man, the song didn't come together all the way like that. Really, my favorite songs off of this was Not The Only One, man, but he's pretty much talking about how people just ain't got no love for him, man. For as many times as he's been down bad, these people that claim they have love for him, they never did shit for him. And which, that's just some true shit that needs to be fucking said on top of a solid beat, man, solid flow. That was by far the best track on him. The second best track on him would be that Jam, which you already know what that's about, man. When you got Trey Songz and Jamie Foxx on the same track and such, then throwing Ty Dolla $ign, this was all his songs geared to the women and such, man, and it actually panned out pretty fucking well. The only other song on here that interests me was that Told Me, where he's pretty much talking about all of the lies and such that people have told him that he's no longer fucking believe him. Like, in the first verse, he's talking about how these dudes who already then came the fuck up and such, how a lot of people think, okay, if you doing your thing, these people will come down to help you. Doesn't happen that way. If these motherfuckers ain't coming down to make no money off of you, they're not fucking with you, or they're not going to try to hold you back to keep themselves up. That's really how that shit works. Second verse, he's rapping about loyalty, pretty much how you're led to believe that the people that you go to jail with, the people that you come up with and shit, these are the people that's gonna remain loyal to you forever, but sadly, that's not the way this shit goes. And this is one of the most heartbreaking things about being in the game and being in life in general, man. Anybody can flip on you at any motherfucking time. Overall, this album was cool, man. For an average rapper, he made average stuff, you dig? I give this joint a 6 out of 10. But this concludes today's review, and now we're gonna jump into brief instrumental from underground producer Hash Beats before we jump into some of your questions. Could be considered as an album of the year because it has some bangers and such in it. But my thing about that is, you really don't hear that about like collaboration albums ever, you did. And it's merely because album of the year is usually dedicated to individual artists who showed out on their own shit. Not so much people who go ahead and grab a whole bunch of artists and throw them all together for one project. That's really just the way these things work, you dig? Like, people don't give you that much credit for putting together a lot of dope MCs on one project. And Robert says you can't compare anybody to 06 to 09 Lil Wayne and such, man. And I mean, Lil Wayne was dope, especially in that time period, but yes, you can compare him to certain people, especially seeing as though there have been some alleged ghostwriting going on with him during that point, from Gilly the Kid, in which if you break down the bars, the way he's writing his shit, kinda similar. I hope you enjoyed the show. You can follow me at Twitter up there, and you can go to downloadpaz.com, that's down there, to read today's article.